Judgment day for a Detroit teen accused of killing a pregnant woman.
A judge ordering him to spend the next 25 to 60 years of his life in prison for the death of the young mother.
7 Action News reporter Shelley Childers explains what he did in that courtroom today that outraged the family.
16-year-old Jeremy Lee was sentenced today for the heinous death of a 29-year-old mother of 4 who was pregnant. In court, the judge called this a senseless and brutal murder. 16-year-old Jeremy Lee will now spend the next 25 to 60 years in prison. In court, our cameras caught him exchanging smiles with a family member as he waited to be sentenced, with the victim's family sitting just feet away. Last month, the teen pled guilty to killing 29-year-old Amanda Lynn Benton from Melvindale. Her family filled the back row of the courtroom, both her mother and father crying as they addressed the judge.
I want to make this clear. He did not murder one person. There were 2 lives taken in the worst way I could have ever imagined.
There's not a night that I don't hear her calling, "Daddy, help me. Daddy, help me."
Investigators say Lee and another man, 23-year-old Jacob Barnes, carjacked the victim in September 2016 in southwest Detroit. They then beat the mother of 4, put her in the trunk of her own car, drove her to an abandoned Detroit home where they beat her some more, eventually snapping her neck and killing her. Her family says she was 5.5 months pregnant with her first daughter. After killing her, police say the 2 set her body on fire.
And then to burn her. So we can't even have a proper goodbye to her. Why burn her?
My daughter had no face. It was burnt completely off.
In court, the family played a picture montage of their daughter's life. The teen refused to look up and watch it. Amanda Benton leaves behind 4 sons, 12, 9, 6, and 5 years old. She was engaged to be married. Amanda Benton's 4 sons are now in the custody of their grandfather. We learned in court that her oldest, the 12-year-old, was diagnosed with PTSD for his mother's death. The second defendant in this case, Jacob Barnes, is set to go to trial in May. For now, reporting from downtown, Shelley Childers, 7 Action News.